Всем салют! Мы на бэкстейдже Booking Machine Festival. Это Илья Мамай, это Джим Бейтвет. Ребят, скажите мне, пожалуйста, вот вы еще не выступали? Какие у вас эмоции до выхода на сцену? Что вы чувствуете?
Чувствую себя как притаившийся дракон.
Как крадущийся тигр себя чувствую.
Крадущийся тигр, затаившийся дракон.
Как рано вы сюда приехали?
Мы в 3 часа дня мы приехали.
Да, мы успели на последние 2 трека мэ.
То есть, получается, вы здесь где-то около 3 часов. Не заебывает ждать?
Не, нормально. Не. Куча народу, куча своих чуваков. Ли-ли-ли, на дым сигареты, левой руке я выкину кеды на
провода. Блоки ебали во что-то, одеты ебали всегда. Вы у нас особенные чуваки, которые играют в слоте ада. У нас три разных слота, соответствующие триптиху Босха, на котором строится вся концепция фестиваля. У нас райская концепция заканчивалась My Waves, сад земных наслаждений заканчивался Маркулом. И вы отчасти открываете ад, часть ада. Что-то особенное приготовили?
Адское пекло.
Bones and Xavier Wolf, please welcome. How do you feel so far? Tired, exhausted?
Yeah, but we did good though. We killed it, and the crowd was great. It's my first time to Moscow. This is his second. So he's killed it once. This is his second time killing it. This is my first time killing it with him. It was lit. It was great. Yeah, we're tired though.
Do you remember your first time in Moscow?
Yeah, it was only a couple months ago. Yeah, it was nice. But I love being with him and being out here is the best.
So it's half of Team Sesh here.
It's so good. Yeah, we got the boys, Team Sesh, Hollow Squad, Water Boys back home, Healthy Boys back home. We need to get them out here. That's all I want.
Oh, when we get them out here, that's when it's really
gonna be fucking over. This shit's just a taste.
Yeah,
it's just an appetizer.
I wanted to ask you about the festival that you joined in America. It was a Rolling Loud festival. Yeah, was it good? Was it your kind of vibe? Or
I feel like anywhere that we go, we kind of make it our shit, you know. Even if, you know, I mean, there could be people playing that are nothing even like us, or that we don't even type of listen to. But it's like we always make it our shit.
Yeah.
Anywhere.
We always kill
there
it.
We go. So
no matter what's going on, we will make sure we kill it. No matter what, doesn't matter.
Какими судьбами вы попали в БМ и что было до этого?
До БМ мы были частью Young Russia какое-то время, и много выступлений у нас прошло вместе с ними в рамках там туров, отдельных каких-то выступлений.
Young Russia был феноменом на самом деле в каком-то...
Да, мы только буквально недавно с Томасом вспоминали, что Young Russia — это легендарно.
Да, легендарный
хуйня. Young Russia в наших сердцах. Какой-то немного даже переломный момент вообще во всей индустрии. Потому что чуваки просто своими силами начали месить и собирать достаточное количество народа для этого.
Не скучаете по тем временам?
Все сейчас было по-другому, сейчас иначе. В любом случае, ну как бы ностальгия в любом случае есть, но мы двигаемся дальше.
Но нынешние фрешмены, они как бы похожи на то, что было в Young Russia, или нет?
Ну чувствуется эхо. Потому что, мне кажется, все эти фрешмены, они выросли на это.
Что-нибудь поменялось у вас с приходом сюда?
Ну, мне кажется, после того, как мы попали на BM, более далекие горизонты стали ближе. И типа wow. Это стимулирует.
Can you tell us about more Team Sesh philosophy? Because I think Booking Machine kind of have something similar with Team Sesh vibe.
We just don't, you know, Sesh, Hollow Squad, Water Boys, Healthy Boys, we just don't, we don't ask for help from anybody. We just do what we want to do, and just, there's really nothing that we want to do that we can't fucking do on our own.
And I feel that your audience is kind of big family around you, because they all supportive.
I feel like it sounds very funny, because at any moment somebody could come up to us and fucking smoke us in the face.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? I really, our fan base shows us this love that is just hard not to reciprocate and give back, and it's just fucking unreal. And like, there's nobody that has a fan base. I mean, everybody thinks their fan base is the best.
Yeah,
I'm sure.
But here's like a family, more than family.
But it's just like at our shows, it's like I can't even fucking explain.
It's like they're a family, bro. Everybody in that room or in that crowd, like they're here for our well-being. If anything happens, if anybody was to like try to do something crazy, like run up on us,
like, dude, trust me, it wouldn't be no fucking kids like just filming ass. With a phone. And we look out for them. Like if we ever see any bullshit, like somebody getting hurt or any fucking weird fights or any of that shit, we always make sure we stop. I mean, here's the thing. It's not good. It's not special. Like, we don't need a pat on the back for that. That's what you should fucking do.
Right.
Like, these people are work so fucking hard to make money, and they choose to spend it with us and come to our shows. And I can't even, like, explain how that feels.
I feel the same about our crowd, because we grown with our crowd.
Yep.
This was the same.
It's about
philosophy.
Growing with them. Yeah. Like, growing up with them and feeling like, you know.
And what age, roughly what age is your crowd?
We've seen it all.
Oh, yeah, bro. Oh, we've seen it all from young kids that
remember,
are like
remember
seven.
Remember in D.C., like the, remember that house party in D.C. a long time ago in the DMV with like the seven-year-old kid?
Yeah.
Somehow he got in there.
Yeah, he got in there. He was turned as fuck. Like, it would go from seven to kids coming with their parents. And their parents fucking with us. So it doesn't, it's all
But
that.
We've had straight up like 45-year-old dudes and girls just at the shows, just enjoying it, just coming there to check out the music. And that's. All ages are welcome. I love it. There's no discrimination.
Yeah, and I also know that you don't tour often. Yeah.
No, we just do it when we want to.
Yeah, we do.
Like,
we
there's
want.
Really nobody that can make us do something. I mean, we're the only reason I think that this worked is because we're all like really fucking hard-headed. Like, we're all really stubborn. Like, none of us will do anything anybody tells us. Like, I didn't fucking finish school. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's like he didn't finish school either. I got 50 shades of gray, they fade to black if I lose. Hold up, I'm smoking seven blunts while I cut up intruders. Rios, they Takahashi, don't even know how I do it. See me smoking special zips and that's just how I'ma do it. If he think he hires me, I just look down and say, prove it. Yo, если есть в зале джойнты, самое время их взорвать.
Почему вместе вот, сотрудничаете? Ну, выступаете, гастролируете, да?
Потому что мы чувствуем.
Вы соседние улицы там?
Нет,
нет, мы
из разных районов.
Просто появилась какая-то синергия еще, наверное, во время того, как
заценили стайлак. Передайте это джой, со мной молодой ранен, голова
в моем патроне, демоны на мониторе. У меня еще вопрос, знаешь, какой? По Текаше. Мы сделали ему большой европейский тур, все анонсировано, идет продажа билетов. Через месяц он становится просто супер большой, попадает в топ билборда и начинает съезжать с контракта. Вот как бы нас он очень сильно подставил. Каким образом вы вообще с ним законнектились?
Я просто респектанул ему за трек, который слушал типа на повторе весь день. Тупо в директе написал. И лег спать, на утро я проснулся, он мне пишет «Let's collaborate when you're ready».
А ты типа English... Окей.
Ну так, типа, хрома.
С Google Translate?
Отчасти.
Чего, как тебе, понравилось с ним работать или там похуй вообще?
Да, на самом деле он, мне, как мне показалось, в этой работе он был заинтересован даже больше, чем я. И все понимали, что у него есть перспективы именно из андеграундных и всех, кто его видел. Он это тоже понимал и стремился во все стороны как-то себя показать везде. И то есть он увидел то, что у нас есть какая-то аудитория в России на тот момент, и решил за нее зацепиться.
Не очень красиво себя повел, на самом деле. Я вот до сих пор храню в сердце обиду. Do you feel yourself that you started something new within the hip-hop culture? Because I think it's really...
Because we're not finna just get on camera and be like, yo, we started this, we started that. But the people know. And we don't ever want to be those people like, oh, we... You know what I mean? But for those who know,
Because nobody started... Like, realistically, you can always trace back inspirations to anything. It's like the only... I film with VHS. I can't say I started that because I do that because of Bam Margera and CKY and Jackass and shit. You know what I mean? Fucking... And Blair Witch and just random shit. And it's just we, the fact that people want to give us the crown and make us like that, we take it with, and it's humbling. It's like, there's, I don't give a fuck, like, how we feel, dude. The thing, people place us so fucking high that we don't even need to say, oh, we started this. Like, the people fucking say it for us.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
And we just, all we can do is make sure we protect that crown and keep it real. Don't change shit we've been doing.
Be yourself.
And that's
but
it, bro.
Also, don't
that's
switch up on the people that have supported us since the beginning. Because we have so many, all of us have loved rappers and all musicians that have fucking changed.
Yep.
So drastically, just for money or just for fucking whatever the fuck they do it for.
Yeah, we also fucking with Suicide Boys. We did their shows and they told me the same. I think you are close friends with them.
They're good guys.
Yeah, they are.
They're good guys, man. They're fucking doing their thing. We couldn't be more proud of them. It's so awesome, man. Anybody who's ever come in contact with me, him, Chris, or Eddie and said, oh, you guys have inspired us, that is fucking so unbelievable. And to see them, Suicide Boys, and just so many other kids that have reciprocated the same love, do big shows and all that, that makes us feel so proud of them.
Yeah.
Because it's just like, shit, man, dude. That's awesome.
It makes us feel good, bro. Because, I mean, they'll tell you, like, we are one of the reasons that they are doing what they're doing.
That's why you really so much music.
Yeah.
The last years, like.
Yeah.
And that's it. What's up?
Y'all looking good, man. I see
can
you.
We,
I finally made it over here, my nigga.
Hey, give it up for my boy Xavier Wolf. First time in Russia.
I love it.
Is there any way we could turn these lights off? Can we turn these blue ones off?
Каким образом отбирали иностранных гостей для этого феста? Потому что, скажем, Бонс и Xavier Wolf, я очень был рад тому, что они приехали, особенно Xavier Wolf, потому что я его тысячу лет уже слушал.
А каким образом мы отбирали?
Ну да, почему вот именно они, например? Это тоже довольно такие звезды андеграунда, из андеграунда, собственно, и вышедшие.
Не знаю, не совру, но 90% артистов, которые с нами работают, это мои личные вкусы. Но если меня прям пропирает, мне очень хочется человека или там группу привести. Вот, и таким образом у нас сложилась история с Боунсом. Я их заметил еще в 2014 году, мы долго переписывались. Никак не удавалось его выцепить вообще, в принципе, из Америки. Он никуда не вылетал. И я до этого привозил Криса Трэвиса, который из его Team Sash команды. У него был менеджер у Криса Трэвиса, который сказал, что Эльмо такой чувак, талантливый, безумный и так далее, но он настолько сам в себе, что его даже из дома не вытащить, потусоваться нереально. То есть, говорит, ты никогда его в жизни не привезешь в Россию.
All right, man. Y'all looking good, bro. I see you.
Hey,
I see.
Make some noise for yourself, motherfuckers.
Okay, I see y'all. Let's get it.
I think the new era of new metal music coming like in next, I don't know, 5 years.
Yeah, man. I hope fucking that shit comes back, and I hope. This is kind of ignorant because it's not like the punk scene or like hardcore scene ever went away, but it definitely dwindled down to a smaller. Like when I was coming up and seeing like fucking like Four Today and La Dispute and all those bands like coming up, like it was fucking so sick. And now I feel like they're so slept on.
You also fucking with Burzum, right?
Oh yeah, man. You know
death metal,
I mean?
And black metal.
Yeah. I love all sorts of music, jazz. Yes. We listen to everything.
You'd be surprised.
Like, there's really not music that turns us off.
Yeah. Какой у тебя был первый привоз?
4 июня 2009 года, когда мы, собственно, букетмашиновскую историю отмечаем, да, это был DubFX, уличный музыкант, которого я увидел... Да, битбоксер. Которого я увидел в Ютубе, меня так вдохновило, я нашел его MySpace, написал ему на MySpace, он приехал, мы договорились там за что-то... За 100 евро, ну, у меня вообще денег никаких не было. То есть, ну, чувак на улице поступает, у него не было никаких клубных концертов ни разу.
А ты его в клуб привез?
Да, я его, типа, привез в клуб, чуть ли там за бесплатно, и тут же собрал аншлаг. Ну, то есть, все билеты были проданы за где-то 2 недели до концерта. Там небольшой клуб был на 300 человек. Потом мы с ним сразу же договорились, чтобы он ночью этого же дня приехал в другой клуб и сыграл там. Первые деньги, которые заработал, вот так вот. Просто ничего фактически не делать, просто создав встречу ВКонтакте.
И это уже сразу было как букинг-машина.
Да, да, да.
Спасибо, Москва, еще увидимся!
Москва!
We also, Booking Machine started from 2009, and we started from bringing underground hardcore bands. So we never worked with hip-hop.
It's so awesome, man.
And we started from like true music.
Yeah, exactly.
Like music for 100 people, 100 kids. And we also learn a lot of from metal music. And that's why I think we can create something better than anyone, because we know how hard it is.
Dude, that's how we feel. I feel like there's a lot of people that can make like sick songs. Mm-hmm. Anybody can make a sick song. Like, have you ever made music?
Of course.
Yeah, it's like, but like, you have you ever made music before?
A little bit.
A little bit? Damn. Well, if there's somebody that would say no, every single person that hasn't made music can make music and has at least one song in them. That's how I feel. I feel like every single person in the world, even if they don't fuck with music, they can make the hardest shit.
Exactly.
So I feel like just
Because it's coming from the heart.
It's important to make music for yourself first before anybody else. That's what the fuck people don't really understand. You got, just like how you say you used to make music, you, as long as you like it, it doesn't give a, doesn't matter if it never leaves the house.
But that,
if you like it, that is all that matters. Other people liking it is a bonus. Never forget that.
Yes. Fuck yeah, dude. Other people liking it is a blessing and a bonus.
But it's for you.
For fucking sure.
And thank you guys for coming.
Thank you, bro. Yeah, we'll be back.
Appreciate it, brother.
We'll be back to do a whole
thing. Beautiful, bro. Beautiful, baby.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Booking machine, baby.